Hello friends, okay. Now so far we have done weak field approach. In that, when crystal field is weaker than the internal electronic repulsions, that time RS term generates and even degeneracy of RS term loses, and therefore these splits into different Mulliken symbols. These total syllabus we saw in earlier videos. Now here, next syllabus or next chapter we can say, that is strong field approach, okay, or we can say correlation diagram. One more terminology is given in the syllabus, that is correlation between weak field and strong field. Okay, now we choose one example. For example, again 3D2 configuration, but this is with strong field, okay, infinitely strong field. And we are not going to do correlation diagram just now. First, we'll finish this 3D2 configuration strong field approach, and then we'll draw the correlation diagram between 3D2 weak field and 3D2 strong field approach. Okay, now we'll start with the strong field approach for 3D2 configuration. So, example 3D2 configuration. And in strong, don't forget that field is infinitely strong than the internal electronic repulsions. Now what happens in the strong field approach? When the crystal field is very strong, what happens to this 3D2? So we know deep 5D orbitals are there. This is 3D orbital with two electrons. So two electrons, and this two electrons splits into, in the octahedral geometry, this is in the T2G and this is the EG set of orbitals. So what happens? These two electrons goes in a, this way we split actually. But when the crystal field is very strong, these two electrons goes into three different configurations. And these three different configurations are, I'll write separately, that is T2G2, EG0, okay. Second will be T2G1, EG1, and third will be T2G0, EG2. Both the electrons in EG2 set of orbitals. So first, both the electrons in T2G set of orbitals. Second case will be one electron is in a T2G and one in a EG, and third will be both the electrons in a EG set of orbitals. Now what we have to do for this each configuration, we have to deal with, and there is a methodology to deal with this each configuration. So first we'll consider the first case, that is first case T2G2 EG0. No need to write EG0, right? Sometimes it is given in the bracket or this way. Okay. Now for this, again there is a methodology. So there are again steps. So obviously step number one, we have to deal with the degeneracy or total multiplicity. So we can calculate total degeneracy of this configuration. Now how to calculate total degeneracy of the configuration? We know that is by using factorial formula. I'll write here factorial, n factorial, small n factorial, n minus n factorial. This we saw when we did the derivation of RS term or microstate table. This n is the total capacity of the orbital. This small n is the actual electrons. Now if we have to do for T2G2, what is the capacity of T2G set of orbital? There are three orbitals, so capacity of 6. So again, this will become 6 factorial divided by 2 electrons, are this 2 factorial, and 6 minus 2 factorial. So this will come. So if we solve this, 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, 2 into 1 and 4 into, so we'll get the answer 15. Okay, so this is the 15 total degeneracy of this configuration. If we do this for the second case, that is T2G1 and EG1, in the same by using factorial formula, we'll get the answer T2G is 6 and EG is 4, so we'll get 24 is the answer for this. And for third configuration, if we do factorial formula, that is when both the electrons in EG2 set of orbitals, we'll get the answer 6. And if we sum up this 15 plus 24 plus 6, we'll get the answer 45. Okay, if you remember, when we did 3D2 microstate table, for that total microstates for D2 configuration in weak field was 45 number. Again, in a strong field, when 3D2 configuration is there and crystal field is infinitely strong, again we are generating 45 different combinations of this. Okay, now we'll solve orbital state and spin multiplicity for each of the configuration. So we start next step. Step number 2. Get the orbital states. Okay, now step 2. For each configuration, we need to take the orbital states. Now, how to take these orbital states? That is from the direct product table. Again, this direct product table is given with the question paper. I am not going to show over here. I will show in the next video what is direct product table. So, from this direct product table, we have to do the T2 into T2. So, if it is a T2G2 configuration, we have to look it into the direct product table. So, we have to see T2 into T2 and G. Because two T2G states are there. So, one and G is outside, which is a Garret function. So, we will end up with orbital states. I will write down here. So, A1G plus EG plus T1G plus T2G. Okay. These are the orbital states for this configuration. So, next, now we got the orbital states. What is the next job? We must have a spin. So, step, next step will be, so we can say step number 3. Here. Now we want spin states for these orbital states. Okay. And how to get these spin states? We have to use the Bede's rule, which is a descending symmetry. We have to lower down the point group, that we have to do for the spin states. So we'll do by following the Bede's symmetry rule of lowering the point group. How to do that? So now for T2G, I'll just write here A1G plus EG plus T1G plus T2G. So this A, B, C, D we are going to see, and that is by using Bede's rule. Okay, now this is octahedral geometry. So we'll write for the convenience, I'll write here A1G, A, and then EG, B, then T1G, C, and T2G D. So we are going to find out this spin multiplicity of these four states A, B, C, D, that is. Now, what is Bede's descending symmetry rule? We have to lower the lower this octahedral point group, so that we will get such a point group. We will choose such a point group which will end into only singly degenerate states, that is A type or B type. And now, if we lower this point group by using correlation diagram, which is given with the question paper, lower to the C2H point group. So this AG will end up with only AG. This EG will end up with BG. T1G will AG plus 2BG. And T2G is 2AG plus BG. Keep in mind, this I have written from the question paper itself. Two pages are given at the end of the question paper. And we call it as a correlation diagram. From that correlation diagram, we have to lower octahedral point group to the C2H point group. So that we will get all states, whatever end up with the singly degenerate states. Okay, A and B type. Okay. Okay. Now here we lowered the octahedral point group to C2H and we end up with singly degenerated A and B type of states. Now what we have to do, we have to choose, we cannot choose this EG to BG or A1G to AG, because only one state, we have two electron combination. So at least there has to be two states so that we can accommodate two electrons. So what I'll do, for the convenience, I'll choose this this state, I mean, CT1G is equal to AG plus 2BG, and I'll make the possible combinations of two electrons which are there in the configuration. So, how to do this? So, T1G C is equal to AG plus 2BG. So, what I'll do, one electron, BG has 2. Therefore, I'll write here 2BG states. Okay. So, this is what I'll do, BG plus BG instead of writing. Okay. Now, we have 3 states and electrons are 2. So, we have to make a combination. So, how many combinations we can make? This is first combination. This is second combination. This is third combination. This is fourth combination. This is fifth combination. And this is sixth combination. Okay. Now, we have two electron combination with six different possibilities. Now, we have to get the, from the direct product table, we have to get the ground state for these combinations. And if we do this with the first page of the direct product table, we get the answer that is Bg is 2 times, okay, 3Bg is 2 times. And this is the ground state for these combinations. We have to use this. Now, we have to check when we did octahedral point group, we have written that ABC, A1G, A, then EG, B, then T1G, C, and T2G, D. Now, with T2G, when we lowered the point group, we have written here, this is C2H. I will not write remaining. So, here we have written AG plus 2BG. So, with EG, there was only 1BG. Here, AG plus 2BG. So, we have to check where is the BG 2 times, and that will be a ground state. So, obviously, BG 2 times is with T on G. Therefore, C is equal to 3 will, right, and rest remaining ABC will be. So, the house spin multiplicities will come A is equal to B is equal to D is equal to 1 and C is equal to 3. Okay, these are the spin multiplicities. Or if I have to write in a proper sense, how I will write, so T2G2, this will be 1 A1G plus 1 EG plus 3T1G plus 1T2G. Okay. So, spin multiplicities I have written for A1G 1, EG 1, C1G T, this will be a ground state, and T2G will be 1. Why I have written 1 and 3 only? Because 2 electrons are there. So, there will be either triplet or singlet. I mean, both will be one will be antiparallel, one will be parallel, that will give you 0 value. If we substitute that S is equal to 0, we will get the 1. Or 1 plus 1, half plus half, we will get 1. If we substitute that half plus half at the place of S into S plus 1 formula, we will get 3. So, we will have an answer only 2 possibilities, 1 or 3. And therefore, CT1G will be 3, and this will be a ground state. Or in other way, we can write this T2G2 here. Ground state will be T1G3, then T2G1, EG1, and A1G1. So, I will just drop this so that there will not be. So, this will be A1G1. Okay. And if I have to do total degeneracy or total multiplicity of these states, what I will do? I'll just do 1 into 1, total spin multiplicity into orbital multiplicity. Orbital multiplicity of A1G is 1 and spin multiplicity. So, 1 into 1, you will get answer 1. Okay. For AG, 1 into 2, AG is a doubly degenerate orbital. So, that will give you 2. 1 into 3 will give you 3. So, here answer will be 3. And 3 into 3 will get answer 1. 3 into 3 will get answer 9. So, if we sum up this, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 9, we will get 15. So, whatever we have calculated earlier by factorial formula, that answer was 15. So, whatever we have done is correct by doing this T2G splitting into the Mulliken states. Okay. This is for T2G. Now, we will do for EG. How EG will be split into Mulliken states when it is in a strong field. Now, when both the electrons are EG2, first we have to get the orbital state. So, from the direct product table, so it will come A1G plus A2G plus EG. Very simple. Okay. These are the orbital states. Now, we want spin state. That means second step is a spin state. That is ABC we want. Again, we have to lower down the point group. So, A1G, A2G, EG, A, B, C. Use the correlation diagram from the question paper, lower it to C2H so that it will give you singly degenerate states. So, it will give BG and this will give you AG plus BG. Okay. So, So here if we now we will select this one C and we'll accommodate two electrons with a different combination. So we can make here three combinations. That is one electron is in Ag, other is in Bg, then both are in Ag, and third time both are in Bg. And if we find out ground state, that will come Bg three times. And we have to check now where is the Bg when we lowered the point group by Bede's rule. Bg is once with C, Eg is equal to this one. Or other time it is with the A2G. Now if we select this one is as a ground state B, A2G is equal to Bg, that means we'll write here A1G 1, then A2G B is equal to 3 and Eg is equal to 1. And if we calculate this by earlier like T1G, T2G, I'll show you what I wanted to say here, Eg2, you split into 3. So here it will come A2G, this will be 3, then A1G, this will be 1, and Eg, this will be 1. If we calculate total multiplicity, so this is doubly really right. So 1 into 2, we get the answer 2. 1 into 1, we get the answer 1. And this will be 3 into 2, we'll get the answer, 3 into 1, we'll get the answer 3. And if we do sum, this will come 6. Again, it matches with the factorial formula calculations, whatever we have done earlier. Now, what I wanted to show, why I have chosen A2G is a ground state, not A1G or EG. If I do that, if AG, BG was with EG also, when we lowered the point, point 2. And it was with A2G. I have not chosen EG. Instead, I chose the A2G. Because if I write A in the place of 1, 3, what will happen? 3 into 2, it will come 6. And 1, 1. So, answer will be 8. And which is not correlating with the factorial formula. So, that would have gone wrong. Therefore, A2G is the ground state. That means EG will split into this way only. And A2G will be a ground state. Okay. Now, third configuration. I'll quickly finish. That is one electron is T2G1 and one electron is Eg1. This is very simple. If we use direct product table to get the orbital states, we will get only T1G plus T2G, only two states. And answer from the factorial formula is 24. How to deal with this? We cannot use Bede's method for here because only two states are there. So what we have to do, we'll simply do by trial and error method. So T1G plus T2G plus T1G plus T2G. I'll just add two more similar states. So what I'll do by trial and error method, again I'll add 3 and 1 for each state. So if I calculate this 3 into 3 plus 3 into 3 plus 1 into 3 plus 1 into 3, I'll get the answer 24. So that means it is correct. Whatever the splitting of T2G1, Eg1, will end up with this 2 T1G and 2 T2G. But once T1G will be 3, once T2G will be 3, then T1G is 1 and T2G is 1. This is the answer. So this way we have to do the strong field approach for 3D2 configuration. Thank you.